So the weather today has been incredibly gloomy and filming has been near impossible. I've been trying for like 2 hours to get the right settings. 2 hours is maybe a stretch. Hi everyone and welcome back, or welcome if you haven't been here before. And if you haven't been here before, please subscribe to be a part of the bilingual family, which is mostly me trying to speak English and sometimes, apparently according to you, it works. So welcome to today's video and welcome to the Project Pen update. So today is the update. Today I'm going to show you how much progress I've made on those products that I have chosen to be in my Project Pen. I have a fair warning for you. There are some exciting bits in here. If you watch my channel, if you're subscribed to my channel, you would have seen in my recent videos that I have shown my Project Pen products every once in a while, and you can see some progress. So there were a few spoilers. First one that I want to talk about is actually the first very exciting Project Pen update of this video, and that is the Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. It's empty. I do think that at the end of my Project Pen video, I said that this would probably be empty near August, and that is 2 months. As you can see, it's completely see-through. There's no yellow texture left inside of this, except for this bit, but so exciting to me because this was one of those products that I really wanted to empty. I really like this like base on my skin for hydration and makeup purposes, but unfortunately it was just not cruelty-free, and I wanted to get a non-cruelty-free product out of my collection. Done and dusted. Bye. So next up is the tinted moisturizer from ColourPop. This is what it looks like. So last time I have mentioned that I don't really particularly like this formula or the shade of it. I'm not gonna constantly review stuff when I talk about it because that will just make this video like a year long, and that is not what I'm trying to do. Last time we were about here, as you can see, and if we press down the product right now, we're about this way. And then if you press it, we're about this far. So right here. So we definitely made some progress, I would say. There's definitely a little bit of progress made with this product, which is exciting. After using it for quite a while, like just using it very regularly, I did find that I was growing a little bit tired of the way that this looked on my skin. And I just wasn't really feeling this product anymore. So then I decided to mix it with other foundations as a way of still using it but getting a different type of finish. I make a little bit less progress right now as I would like by mixing it with other foundations, because obviously you're not using as much as you are when you're using it on its own. But I was really tired of this product, and I really didn't feel like using it anymore. So by mixing it, I kind of found a way to still use it. Yeah, in 2 months, I would like to see a little bit more progress, if not like completely finished, by mixing it with other foundations or using it on its own. The next up is concealer, and for concealer I chose the Essence Camouflage Matte Concealer. This is another exciting update. I did mention in my last video that this was gonna be empty, and that is because I used concealer so many times, and here we go. It's empty. So this is what it looks like, completely empty. Very exciting in my opinion. I did clean it because otherwise you couldn't really see the emptiness of it, but basically it's gone. Because this is a concealer that I did like using it, but I wasn't necessarily, like, it's not my favorite concealer in the entire world, you know? After concealer comes powder, and the powder that I chose was the Hourglass Veil Translucent Setting Powder. I didn't have a lot left in the powder anymore. I have been consistently using that powder for like 2.5 years, I think, by now. So I really felt like it was time for me to use it up and let it go. And I did mention, I don't know what I mentioned in my last video about this powder, but it's empty. So this is again another empty. I have 3 empties, if I'm not mistaken, in this Project Pen, which is amazing. I did try and clean this, but that was pretty much impossible. At the end I was really struggling to get any kind of powder out of it. So I was always like doing this, making sure that it landed in the center, and then being like this just to get some product out. I'm really happy with this because this took a really long time to finish up, and now I have 2 powders left, which is amazing. So for bronzer, I chose the Nabla Skin Bronzing in the shade Ombra. So I did mention this bronzer in my top 3 bronzers. That is still correct. It's just a very difficult progress. It's just a very difficult product to pen, and I wanted to give myself a real challenge because other products in this project pen are a little bit easier, were things that I was already nearly empty with, you know, they're not completely filled. So I don't have the most progress on this, I have to say. It's definitely not a product that I did use it almost every single day, and you can, I think you can see that the mark has faded even more. So not a whole lot of progress or visible progress on this bronzer, but I have been using it every single day, and I think in real life you can definitely see that there is more progress and that I've made a difference. It's also the one that I have on my skin right now. Then next up we have blush, and this is also quite an exciting one, I would say. It's definitely something that I made. Oh yeah, I didn't even address my hair. I have this color now. I managed to create a very unique kind of gray where it has like green and blue and purple undertones. But I'm living for it, so this is my hair now. I had the Makeup Academy blush liquid cream blush in the shade Taupe Tango. This is just one that I, you know, I didn't want my first project pen to be too difficult, to be honest, and I didn't want to give up halfway. Ta-da! So as you can see, I did use it quite a lot. It's also the blush that I'm wearing on my face right now. And last time we were about here. And right now, if we push everything down, I actually made quite a big difference on this. We are about this far right here. So about this much. I'm gonna mark everything later on so we can see. So this is, I think, a blush that I will finish up in the next update, which is very exciting. So next up we have highlighter, and I think I have shared this in my recent videos, the other products not that much. The Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Freestyle Highlighter, especially in the shade Lightning Dust. So this is what it looks like. We have a pen right here, a very big pen right now. It wasn't as big as it was in the beginning. Actually, a week after I did my project pen video, like when I published it, a week after that I penned it, and it was actually quite quickly. I didn't know that I was that close to hitting pen on this product. Again, it was something that I used quite frequently, and I knew I was close, but I didn't think I was that close. I have decided to probably extend the project pen to the shade as well. There's a little bit of a dent in it right now. So yeah, you can see a little bit of a dent in this product. Not that much. Oh, there you go. There you can see it clearly. So those were all of the base products, so everything for the face. Now we move on to the eyes. And the eyes, so the two eyeshadow palettes that I chose to be my long-term project pen are the ColourPop It's My Pleasure palette and the Juvia's Place Afrique palette. In the Afrique palette, I mentioned that I didn't really know what to do with a color scheme. Spoiler alert, I did a lot of looks with this, and I do think that I finally managed to find a way to kind of look at this palette in the correct way and see what kind of shades you can use together. This is what it looks like. I have to be a little bit careful with the top shades because these two shades, because they pop out. It's a very pigmented formula, so you don't need a lot, but I definitely have some progress in a few shades, so we're gonna try. So the shade that I have the most progress on is definitely Angelique. It's a little bit difficult to see on camera, but that shade I definitely have some progress on, as well as Kofi, Kisi, Cameroon, and Côte d'Ivoire. I do have to mention that you can't really tell the difference or the progress in the shadows on camera, but in real life you can feel the dent. So yeah, there is some progress on this palette. I have come to really like the color palette, like the color story that it has, especially in combination with the more purple tones of the ColourPop It's My Pleasure palette. I've created a lot of looks that I really, really like. Now for the It's My Pleasure palette, this is a little bit more of an exciting update because we have hit pen in one shade, and all of the other ones look really, really used. So this is what the It's My Pleasure palette looks like right now. The progress in like mattes are always a little bit difficult to see, but there is definitely a dent in Kittenfish, a little bit of a dent in Sleeper, and a little bit in Fanfiction. And Earthshine is one that we have penned. So I managed to pen Earthshine because it's basically the shade that I use every single time that I use these two palettes, except for today. I was very excited to pan Earthshine, and at the same time I was kind of bummed because I really wanted to pan a matte shade in this palette. So I think I will probably carry on with the project pan on this one as well, and I'm gonna focus a little bit more on Kittenfish, because Kittenfish is a really nice, it's like this very light lilac-y color, and it's a color that I really like to apply all over the lid for every day when I'm staying in. Now we're on to the last couple of products, which is lips, and oh boy, oh boy. There is one specific lip product that I didn't necessarily like the most when I was using it. It's just because I don't really wear this color that often, and it's basically the Essence Late 8-Hour Lip Liner in the shade 01 Curious. I'm really trying to use this, but it's just not happening as often as I would like it to, that's just because I just don't really like the color. This is how much we still have left. I think there is some difference. I'm not sure if it's a lot of difference. I have to do more looks where I can actually use this lip liner, and then things will be alright. Now, onto the lipsticks. There's also quite a sharp difference between these two in terms of how many times I've used these. I had ABH Kiss and I had Colourpop Was Your Sign. I'm actually gonna start with ABH Kiss because this is the one, again, that I've been using the least. I don't know how much progress we're gonna see on this one. So this is how much we have left of this. I did use it a few times in the past 2 months, but not as much as I would have liked to. Next up we have the Colourpop What's Your Sign lipstick. So this is, I think, a lipstick that I didn't make some progress on. This is how much we have left of this lipstick. So this is how much we have left of this particular lipstick. Not a whole lot, obviously, in terms of progress. The one that I have used the most out of the lip products, because it's a nice neutral one. It's definitely one of like the lipsticks that I frequent the most because of the tone, because of the color, and etc. So next up we have the Nabla Shine Theory lip gloss in the shade District. This is, I would say, this is like a decent amount of progress. It's not anything super, I have to say, in the lip department my progress isn't that major, so this one isn't as bad as I was thinking. So you can see that there are some gaps in this product, and it definitely indicates that it's nearly empty, and especially when I hold it against the light, I can see you can definitely see that it's almost empty. It's just that I have to use it more. So that is basically everything for my project pen update. So we have 3 empties, we have hit pen on 2 products, and we have some significant progress and some not so significant progress. I have decided not to replace them with products that I want to put in a new project pen. I am just going to use products that I have in my collection already, and I'm gonna try and really focus on the products that I have in front of me right now, especially the lips. So the other ones are just gonna be random, but like I said, 3 empties is not bad at all. I'm really happy with that. I really can't talk anymore, so I apologize. Leave a like or a comment down below if you really enjoyed this video, and let me know what you want to see next, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.